Today we'll prepare puri bhaji. So we have this puri is with the wheat flour or chapati atta, and then the bhaji with potato bhaji. So for that we have first we'll have the bhaji. So 500 grams of potato to be boiled, peeled and cut into small bits. Then we have mustard seeds, that is 1 teaspoon, half a teaspoon of uri dal or black gram dal, and this is cumin seed or jeera, half teaspoon, one small onion to be chopped, or you can even slice it and half it, and then one small piece of ginger to be chopped, 2 green chilies, about 15 curry leaves, a little bunch of cilantro or coriander leaves, and that is for the bhaji. And this is turmeric powder, maybe 3/4 teaspoon of turmeric powder, little salt, little water, and we require little oil for seasoning the mustard seeds and curry leaves and onion. So we will first I'll cut this up and keep it, and then we will prepare the bhaji, the potato bhaji. Making the bhaji, so I kept a pan here with about 2 tablespoons of oil, and when it's hot I'll be adding mustard seeds, uri dal seeds, that is black gram, and cumin seed. Okay, so when the started scattering, now I'll add the ginger and green chilies. Now the onion. Let it fry. And once it is fried slightly, then we'll add the turmeric powder and asafoetida, little, I didn't mention it earlier, so little asafoetida and turmeric powder, little, and turmeric powder. So the onion is slightly brown, add little turmeric powder, about 1/2 teaspoon, and a pinch of asafoetida. Mix well. Now we add the curry leaves and fry for some time, about 30 seconds or so. Now we add the potatoes, boiled, peeled and cut potatoes, little coriander leaves, half of this maybe, and keep rest for garnishing, put little salt, about 1 teaspoon of salt. Mix well, then add water and keep it on slow fire for about 5 minutes, about 3/4 cup water. Mix it well and close it and keep it on slow fire for about 5 minutes. We will check. It should be slightly wettish, not very dry, and then check for salt. Yes. Now we add the coriander leaves, rest of the coriander leaves, give one mix and take it off. That's it, potato bhaji. Please.
We have 3 cups of chapati atta or chapati flour, wheat flour, whole wheat flour. That is 3 cups, and then we have about 3/4 teaspoon of salt. We put little salt, sprinkle salt, and little oil. 1 teaspoon of 1 tablespoon of oil. And then water, and knead it little by little. You put water and knead it into a dough, and once the dough is formed, then you make the puris. Nearly done, kneaded, and then now we'll make small ball. That is for the puris. You can make slightly bigger if you want, depending on the size of the puris. And then we'll roll them. So we require some more chapati flour while rolling the puris. Put little wheat flour on that. Make it bigger if you want, but small size, this size will be fine. And go on preparing the rest of the puris. And when you are ready, you fry, deep fry it in puris. So we have a deep pan, oil. Now the oil is hot. Now I'll be dropping this one by one puris, and then as it comes up, just keep it pressed. Yeah. And then give about 10-15 seconds and then turn it. Remove. Next one. Again. Press it. And then again, after some time, turn it. Let it fry on the other side and then remove it. This way, fry all the puris. Puris are nearly fried everything, and that's it, puris. And now I'll show you later on puri, bhaji, and you can have it with the sambar also. So I prepared sambar a couple of days back. So puri, bhaji, sambar, or coconut chutney also would be good with that, along with this accompaniment. We have now puri, bhaji, and sambar.